Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. Today, in this video, I'm going to show you how to install PyCharm. And after that, I'm also going to talk about how you can easily run a simple Hello World Python program on our PyCharm IDE. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, you can put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install PyCharm, first you need to go to your favorite browser. I'm logging into Google Chrome. And I'll just simply type PyCharm download and hit enter, and it's going to show you this download PyCharm Python IDE for professionals. So just simply open that, and it's going to redirect to the official site of JetBrains. So JetBrains only developed our PyCharm, so you can see that PyCharm professional is available to download, but we are not going to download the professional one. We are going to download the community one. So here you can see that PyCharm community edition is there, right? So you have to click on this download button, and when you click on that, it's going to start downloading our PyCharm. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and you can see that our PyCharm community edition is already been downloaded over here. So you have to just simply double click on the installer in order to install it locally on our system. So it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes and welcome to PyCharm community edition setup. So let's minimize our download directory, and here you need to click on next. So this is where our PyCharm is going to be installed. Click on next. Here under installation options, it has given you some checkboxes, right? So from here, you need to select this PyCharm community desktop shortcut. So it's going to create a desktop shortcut over here. And also it is important to select this open folder as project. So what happens is, if you have any Python project folder, so if you just simply right click on that folder, it's going to show you this additional option as open folder as project, right? And we are coding it in Python, so we are going to select this .py, and this is the most important part, to select this add bin folder to path. So what happens is, it's going to automatically set our bin folder path in our environment variable, all right? So that's a very important step, and it also required to restart your system. So I'm going to talk about at that exact point when you need to restart your system. So don't worry, just, you know, keep on watching this video. So here, now just simply click on next. So it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is again fine. Just simply click on install, and there you go. You can see that our installation has rightly began, right? So it has also created a desktop shortcut over here, PyCharm Community Edition. So you can always click on the show details to see how it is installing. So it will take some time, you know, about a couple of minutes. So once we are done with that, we can take it back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see it is telling that it is completing our PyCharm community edition setup. So this is the time you need to, you know, reboot your system. So you need to select this reboot now and to click on finish to start rebooting your system. So after successfully rebooting your system, I'll be again back to this video. You guys also need to do the same. Alright. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, we'll be again landed over to our desktop. So here to just simply double click on the PyCharm Community Edition to start launching our PyCharm. So before that, it will ask you whether you have previously installed PyCharm so that you can import old settings. So I don't have installed PyCharm earlier, so I'll just keep this default, that is do not import settings, and click on OK. And you can see welcome to PyCharm, right? So let's maximize this, and here you can, you know, click on this create a new project and give a project name. So project name currently is given is Python project. I'll change it with, you know, Hello World project, right? And it's going to install the latest version of Python, which is version 3.12 on our system, which is again fine. Just select this create a main.py welcome script as well, and we are not going to use GitHub for now, so I'm not going to select this. We'll keep this unchecked and click on create, and you can see it is started, you know, installing our Python first. So it is downloading our Python and going to install it locally on our system. So now it will take some time. You need to have active internet connection also so that you can fetch the file and can install it, right? and you can see that our project is successfully opened over here. So let's maximize this. So it has also opened our main.py file, and this is our project, hello world project, right? So it has also installed our PyCharm. So currently it is, you know, updating some of the packages. So you can see, click on show all, you can see it is updating our indexes, updating our Python interpreter, scanning some of the files, right? So, you know, let it get finish all the background task first. And you can see that all our background task is completed. So our project is properly open now. So they have already given one template. So this is print high method. So they are calling this print high from our main method by passing a parameter called PyCharm. So this PyCharm is getting over here and going to print high PyCharm. So when you click on the run button, what it's going to do is it's going to start building our project, and after that it's going to show you the output high PyCharm. Let's say you change that with geeky syntax, right? So if you change that with geeky syntax and click on run button, it's going to again start building our project, and after successfully run, it's going to show you high geeky syntax, right? So whatever you are passing over here, you're going to get the same in our result, right? So yeah, that's how you install latest version of PyCharm on a Windows operating system. If you face any issues in middle, you can always put a comment in your comment sessions. I'll try my best to help you. And I have also started one blogging channel. So if you are interested, you can always subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So recently I was in Kashmir. So I have posted one video about Dal Lake. So if you're interested, you can always watch this video. You can subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So yeah, that is pretty much all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That really helped me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.